guys can sit down now. Who ever thought that this band would play the fucking Constitution Hall? And I didn't even think they'd let us in this fucking joint. But it's nice to be here. I haven't been home in a long time, so it's nice to be here. So, we've only done a few of these shows. We haven't done a bunch. We've done maybe like 10 of these acoustic gigs. And they're a fucking blast, man. It's so much fun because, you know, we just made a record where there's one CD that's acoustic stuff on, and there's the rock CD, and we did all that touring, we did all that stuff. And then there's the CD with the acoustic stuff on it. And we always knew that we were going to come out and do this, but I didn't realize how much fun it was going to be. When we first started rehearsing it, we were sitting down, you know, and I thought, this isn't going to be a fucking show, you know, this is going to be like a recital or something. It's not, how are you going to turn that into a gig? And I think what we found in the last 10 shows is that the greatest part is at the rock gigs. I don't really get a chance to sit down and talk to everybody, so how you doing? It's nice to see you. So as you'll find, I'm a blabbermouth. I like to talk shit a lot, all night. So get comfy, because I'm a loudmouth. Anyway, we're gonna play the stuff off of the new acoustic record, but we're also gonna play a bunch of old songs too. Orchestra put together. This song is off of the acoustic record. Hey, Katie, how you doing? Hey, it's my neighbor, Katie. Oh, thank you very much for that. In the middle of the yank. That's cool. That's cool. It's not a fucking baby shower, you know what I'm talking about? It's rock cake, sort of. Thank you, though. That's very nice. This song is off of the acoustic record. This song is called On the Mend, and it sounds like this. Check it out.
thing about doing this kind of show is that we're still discovering songs to do acoustic versions of. And My Hero's a good example of, like, we didn't do it the first 10 shows, and someone said, "What about My Hero?" And it kind of worked out. That was nice. But you know, most of our songs are written on an acoustic guitar, and that's why it kind of works when we take them back like this, because usually, I don't sit around watching TV with the fucking Marshall stack behind me, you know. It just doesn't work that way. Sit around doing nothing with one of these, and you wind up with a bunch of songs and that we record. Well, we used to record it over in Alexandria, just outside of Old Town.
Straps on the inside.
See, Danny's a photographer. He's taking, his name's Danny Clinch. And, what the fuck are you doing, Patrick? What happened, man? You go, okay. Yeah, so Danny, he's taken pictures for our records before. And on this album, he came while we were making it, while we were recording, the day we were recording the song, he came by, and he was taking pictures. And I'm like, dude, fuck, put a harp on this thing. And, he went in and he put a harp on it, and then he quit the band. But now he's here, he's out here, and he's filming this tour because I think we're going to make a little movie out of this whole thing. So, let's see what we're doing. But I think he's really just here to play harmonica every night. He likes the attention. Okay, yeah, well, I guess I'll introduce some band members now. Want to? So as you can see, we've got a little extended lineup here. We've got a bunch of friends, people that we've known for a long time, people that we've played with before, people that have been in bands that we've played with before. And so we'll start with Pat Spears here today. We'll be right back. motherfucker can rock a triangle like nobody's business. Plus, if you're nice, we might get him to do the Bruce Springsteen dance with the tambourine at some point in the game. At some point in the gig. You realize I'm filming, right? You gotta immortalize that shit, brother. Cowbell. Yeah, you don't have a cowbell, do you? You got all that shit, you don't have a fucking cowbell?
Thank you.
Joe Beebe, let's hear it for Joe Beebe, expert guitar player. Joe Beebe, sure enough. To my right is the rippingest guitar player of the evening, Mr. Chris Shipley, the shredder. This guy can be running for money right here.
Same on this side, pal. Same on this side.
It's the same on this side of the table.
Right over here.
You want to sing a song?
Sure, what the hell. I'm here.
You want to sing You Are So Beautiful?
You are so beautiful. Or I can do the...
You don't know me, but...
That's for you, Les.
Yeah. Double feature. That's a double feature right there.
It's a double feature?
Yeah, because I did my two drummer, you know, well, you know, three drummers, really.
Anyway.
Sorry, I'm not the one who gets to do the jokes around here.
Yeah, but that one about being the white concert was funny, though. Your jokes are good, dude. You're funny.
I'm just not as consistent as you.
Taylor, do we need a timeout?
My time is growing thin.
know, first of all, let's hear it for Frank Black opening up the show tonight. That's an honor. It's very nice. You know, after a while, when you're 22 and you go out on the road, you can imagine what kind of trouble you get into. And now, at this point, we go out on the road, and I've got the fucking Swaddlers, and I've got the Discovery Map, and I've got the Baby Einstein, and I've got, what else? Lots of pacifiers, and lots of baby shit. And fortunately, Frank Black brought his four children on the road, so backstage, it's no longer like a Scarface outtake. It's more like a rump room outtake. It's nice. It's nice. It's very nice to come to a show and you know, hide the whiskey or whatever. Different vibe. This song I'm gonna dedicate to my daughter, and it's off of the new record, and it's called Miracle.
Time again.
wait, stand up. No, I'm kidding. No, sit down. No, wait, stand up. It's nice to come out and do stuff like this because, you know, going out on the rock tours, it's super fun. And you go out and sweat and scream and bruises and whiskey and whatever. And that's this is something else. And what I like to do with some of these songs is kind of explain where they're written and the, you know, where they come from. And this song, you know, I grew up here playing music, and then I was in a hardcore band from DC called Scream. Our band kind of split up while we were on the West Coast. Really, you guys can sit down. This is going to be this is a long story. This might take a minute. I want you to lose circulation or anything. I moved out to, the band was on the road. This is in 1990, and the band kind of broke up while we were in Los Angeles. And the singer and the guitar player were brothers. Their sister lived in Los Angeles, Sabrina, and she was a mud wrestler at the Hollywood Tropicana. So she lived in this house with some of her co-workers. And we didn't, you know, we were in a van and had no money, and we had a Canadian roadie, and so we were having his social security checks sent down to Los Angeles so that we could cash them and eat hot dogs and beans, and which I still love, to corn dogs especially. And anyway, so yeah, my corn dogs. Anywho, so I had a mutual this friend of mine, this guy Buzz, who played in a band called the Melvins, and I called him up, and I said, yeah, man, if you come into town, we're stuck here, and we're kind of breaking up. He said, wow, well, he said, have you ever heard of Nirvana? I said, yeah. But at that point, they had one record out on Sub Pop, this record called Bleach. And I heard it, and I thought it was cool. And he said, they're looking for a drummer, and they just came to see your band a couple nights ago. And they thought, good, so you should call them. So long story short, I called them up, and I moved up to Olympia, Washington, which I kind of hated, because it wasn't that bad. It was okay, but it was. I mean, it's beautiful here. We have seasons, and it's wonderful. You have snow, and you have fall, and you have summer, and there's fireflies and stuff like that. Olympia, Washington. There's loggers and hippies, and it rains 8 months out of the year. And it was all right, but the place that Kurt and I, we lived in this little apartment that was such a fucking shithole, man. It was like, it was in the back of the house, and it was basically a living room, a tiny kitchen, and a bedroom. And there was no TV, and there was no radio, and there was nothing. There was really just a guitar in the corner of the room. And I'd never met Chris or Kurt before, and so I started living with them, and I thought they were fucking right off the bat. And so I was a little lonely, a little far away from home, and had nothing to do all night. And we would sit in this apartment and basically just kind of stare at the floor for 12 hours until it was time to go to practice again or whatever. And so I wrote a song while I was there about these two guys that I just joined the band. It's on the new record. It's called Friend of a Friend. It sounds like this.
He needs a quiet room with a lock to keep him in.
Yeah.
only thing I'll ever ask of you. Gotta promise not to stop when I say amen. She sang. She's